On the one hand, entrepreneurship students have some fear of overwhelm associated with finance. And this is normal, because really, understanding finance and using tools like spreadsheets takes a high level of sophistication and a lot of brain cycles. And to an entrepreneurship student, it can be more scary, especially because most of it is guesswork. On the other hand, to be an entrepreneur, you've got to be more than just a visionary. You've got to be more than a creative product guy. You've got to be a business person, right? But being a business person means that you pay attention to finance. We believe that finance doesn't have to be that scary. But now the question is, how do we teach financial modeling in a robust way that doesn't overwhelm our students? So within ExEC, the Experiential Entrepreneurship Curriculum, we have designed the Financial Projection Simulator. This is a fun way for students to experiment with their financial model and to play with a tool that should feel a little more like a game than a traditional flat balance sheet, so they can more deeply engage with the exercise compared to normal accounting activities. Students will play with a rigorous bottoms-up financial projection approach to identify their revenue streams and their costs in a more realistic and reliable way. I mean, instead of guessing huge numbers with large inaccuracy with the top-down TAM/SAM/SOM estimate. So for instance, this industry, it's worth $100 billion, and if we get 10% of it, but since we're conservative, we consider only 1%, and even if we get only 1% of it, we will be rich, right? But this approach doesn't seriously take into account real-world difficulties and real cost of customer acquisition that can seriously damage the viability of a business model. So students start to work backwards with smaller, more meaningful, more concrete and manageable elements they can play with, such as the price of their solution, the number of annual purchases a customer will make. Then they choose which channels they're gonna use to acquire customers and the relative conversion rates. And then with a bottoms-up financial projection, the simulator calculates their total revenue. But at the same time, they will also have the reality check of how much those same channels would cost to them to acquire their customers. In fact, we are providing students with a full list of customer acquisition costs for the main popular channels, such as Google, Facebook, YouTube, and so on. Students also have guidelines to estimate their full-time employees' salaries, taxes, and benefits. For instance, how much a software developer, a designer, or a marketing manager cost in real work? They also have a full guide to calculate their real estate expenses, but also their IT, their administration, their operative unit cost, and more. Once students have filled in their expenses blocks, they can immediately answer the question, is my business model viable? Because they can have in real time a reality check if their business model is viable. If it is a sort of, so then it needs some tweaks, or if it is not viable at all. So students can keep playing to find a financial model that is sustainable.